Good afternoon. The first item of business is time for reflection, and our time for reflection leader today is Reverend Dan Robertson, the Minister at Davidson Mains Parish Church.
Presiding Officer, members of the Scottish Parliament, thank you for the opportunity to address you this afternoon. I wonder what your earliest memory of the Nativity story is. Maybe you got to play a part when you were at school. And if you did, I wonder what part you played. And I wonder what you thought of that part. Because there was a definite pecking order. Even at that young age, we knew it. Top billing, Mary and Joseph. Then there was Angel Gabriel and wise men. Below them were the angels in the choir. Then there were the lowly shepherds. The higher the billing, the more important you were, the closer you got to be to Jesus. I remember the Joseph of my nativity feeling that being Joseph made him a somebody rather than a nobody. And some of that came out in not good ways, because thinking that you're a somebody and others are nobodies has a habit of coming out in not good ways. I know about Joseph because it was me. What I missed as a five-year-old and for many years was that the Christmas story turns the whole pecking order on its head. It speaks of a teenage mother, a carpenter stepdad, outsiders, and those looked down upon shepherds being invited to get up close and personal with Jesus, who Christianity claims is actually God. It speaks of self-important King Herod being repelled. And the Christmas story speaks of a loving, down-to-earth God who comes into this beautiful and broken world to save us from I'm a somebody and they're nobody inclinations. Christ at Christmas calls us to reconsider the pecking order, way of living, which either sinks us when we fail to live up to other people's standards or our own, or puffs us up with pride and leaves us looking down on others. The Christmas story calls us to consider that we are all more fragile and insecure and self-centered than we care to think, and more loved, welcomed, and wanted than we dare to believe. It goes on to deliver the good news that in Christ we have a God dying to love us, dying to forgive us, and dying to be our friend. One whose love is stronger than death. If he rose from the dead, as is claimed. Jesus invites us to consider our value, the value of others, and how close to him we want to get. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Thank you, Reverend Robertson.